Hello everyone, happy Chinese New Year. This is LT. Thank you for watching this video, and this is my first time to share a video on YouTube in this Tiger Year. The reason I set up this channel is mainly to share something useful at work, or anything that's worth to share from my daily life. And today's topic is data visualization, which is the key and most exciting part in data analytics. So what is data visualization? And here's what I found from Google search. Data visualization is the graphical representation of information and data. By using visual elements like charts, graphs, and maps, data visualization tools provide an accessible way to see and understand trends and patterns in data. And from this definition, we can have two ways to look in data visualization. The first one is creating visuals from raw data to tell a story. And the other one is looking at visuals in order to understand about data and identify insight for decision making. For better understanding, let me share an example here. And in this example, I have prepared a data set, which is the sales figures of a series of products in Asia in 2020. If we scroll down, total around 2,000 rows. So there's many data in this table. It's quite difficult to see any meaningful answer by just looking at this table. And the way we make sense of this data is to transform the data set to a visual dashboard like this. We can see three different tracks on this dashboard. And it's dynamic with control panels that allow you to select the data you want to see from the chart. For instance, if we look at the line chart here, we see the sales performance was the best in Q1 and then slow down in Q2 and also drop slightly in Q3 and Q4. With the consideration of all the city here. But if we take out the top three big city here, what will happen? Let's try. If we take out Singapore, Hong Kong, and Taipei, what happened to this line chart? We found that in Q1 was the worst performance for the rest of these cities, and Q3 was the best. Just to show how we can use this dashboard in different scenarios and see the respective answers directly from these charts. And this is also the power of data visualizations. After showing the visual dashboard, here becomes another question. What makes a good visualization? For this, I would like to use the visual made by David McCandless. The graphic here contains four key elements: data, story, role, and visual. And for the coming exercise, I'm going to show you step by step how to create a visual dashboard with the consideration of all these four key elements. So let's start. For data, we will use the same dataset just prepared. But of course, you can also use any other data set for your own interest, study, or business need. And then we need to ask ourselves a question. What you want to see from the data set? The story you want to tell your audience. And in this exercise, I choose a story line about consumers' seasonal buying behavior in different cities. For this objective, we need to find out the data correlations below here about the quarterly sales performance, the sales performance percentage by different brand, and also quarterly sales in different cities. So let's go through these three different data correlations one by one and start with quarterly sales. For this, we need to insert a profit table. And for the range, we just select all the data from the dataset. And here we can find different views for this perfect table. And because this is related to the quarter and also the sales, so we need to take date and revenue. And then we take out the blank and unnecessary items and change this format to dollar. And then insert a chart. And here we will use a night chart here. After we insert this night chart, we also hide this necessary field to make the chart bigger. Also, this is not necessary. And this total is also, we just deleted. Then the next one is about the sales performance in percentage by a different brand. Again, we insert the perfect table. And for the range, the same. We select all the data from the dataset. This time is about sales performance, so that's related to the revenue, and by different brand. So we take the brand, okay. Again, we take out unnecessary items and change this format to dollar. Insert a chart again, and this time we will use a pie chart. We hide all the fields on the chart to make it bigger again. And then we go to the next one. It's about the quarterly sales in different cities. So for this, again, we insert the perfect table. We select all of the data from the data set. And this time, we look at this is quarterly sales, quarterly. Quarterly means related to date, and then sales is related to revenue. And in different city, we select the city. Okay. But from this table, it is quite difficult. This doesn't look good. So we just move the city from rows to columns. And again, we unkick the unnecessary items here and change the format to dollar. Insert a chart. And this time we will use the bar chart. Again, we hide all the unnecessary information here. After that, we go to the dashboard. I already decided the layout of the dashboard earlier here. And it really depends on how many charts we are going to put here. And film color and pictures may also need to match your company or product. If you're interested, we can have another session to discuss about the dashboard design. So let's insert the first chart here. Copy. And then put it here. So you can see that the color of this chart doesn't really match well with in this dashboard. So we need to change the color. So we just right click and then format chart area. And then we can select no field. And also for test options, is fill with white color. And for this line, we also need to change the color from blue to red. Okay, that looks much better. We may also need to, would like to change the display unit from none to a million. Okay, then we can insert another chart. Copy, and then here, paste it. We also need to change the format. And we also need to insert the data label in this chart. Also the same for the last chart. We copy and then paste here. For the interest of time, I skip the details of the format modification of the charts. The next most important step is to insert the slicer in the control panel. So we select one of the chart and then insert slicer and let's set the date here for the first slicer. And then also need to change this format and also need to right click, select the setting and hide item with no data. Okay. And then the most important thing to make the report connections. And we select the connections between this field chart. So it works okay. And the same to insert another slicer. We select any one of the chart and then insert slicer. And then this time we select city. We change the format. And also the column, we want to make it to two columns. And also hide item with no data. And the most important step is to make the connection, report connections between these three charts. Also the same for the last slicer with the brand. And then we can have a visualization dashboard like this. You can choose by different city and different brand, and also different quarters. So congratulations, you have just learned one more skills for your work or for your study. So if you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave your comments below. Please also share and like this video if you enjoyed and found it useful. Thank you and see you next time. Bye-bye.